morning and welcome to MTV's news update for today, Wednesday, May 17, 2017. I am Ashley Scotland with your top headlines for tonight. New ombudsman identified. Seaman found dead with gunshot to the back of his head. Executive arm of government not impeding on the judiciary's functions, says President David Granger. Carter Center recommends changes to the electoral process. Development in Region 9 progressing on the new REO. Drug shortages in Linden being rectified. And in court, Alvin Hotskull Jones remanded for murder. Now for the news and details. A Martin Street worker arrested Georgetown welder and his mother is in custody for unlawful possession of a firearm, ammunition and narcotics. About 18 hours yesterday, the welder was observed by police rounds on Norton Street, acting in a suspicious manner. A search of his person revealed an unlicensed .32 Taurus pistol with four live matching rounds. The suspect was escorted to his home, where in the presence of his 50-year-old mother, a search was carried out and live .38 ammunition and 3.5 grams of cannabis were found in a room. The latest seizure of firearm has brought the overall tally to 49 for the year. Following the death of the ombudsman in September 2016, President David Granger met with opposition leader Barrett Jagdeo this morning to discuss the selection of a new ombudsman. Find out more from Nikhil Jondo.
The two met at State House in the presence of Minister of State Joseph Harmon and opposition member Irfan Ali. In an invited comment, President David Granger says Justice Winston Paterson will fill that vacant position of ombudsman, which has been left vacant after the passing of retired Justice Winston Moore.
That's correct, yes. We had to, in accordance with the Constitution, we had a consultation on the appointment of the ombudsman.
Former President Donald Ramatar had appointed Justice Winston Moore in January 2014. The ombudsman's office is an independent, impartial body providing free services in investigating complaints that have not been solved by an organization or public body that the complaint is against. An ombudsman will also investigate complaints of cases that have been handled poorly or unfairly, making someone to suffer as a result. Nikhil Jondo reporting for MTV News Update.
More news still ahead, do stay tuned. Out at Home Sense Wholesale and Retail, 31 Traque Farm, East Bank, Demerara, for your household items such as carpets, mats, vases, stand fans, kitchen utensils, etc. We have in stock office chairs, plastic chairs, tents, outdoor patio sets, trampoline, children's wings, and much more. Also remember to check out our second branch at 93 Grove Public Road. Visit us today for the best deals and amazing prices on adult and children footwear, undergarments, children book bags, lunch bags, bicycles, beach chairs and accessories, baby care items, and a whole lot more. So the next time you're thinking about going shopping, remember to visit Home Sense Wholesale and Retail. Telephone numbers 638-6861 or 619-8502.
Rice farmers, my name is Beaufort Adams from BLT Enterprise Inc. Guyana Real Rice Crop Enhancer. Return to a higher production and productivity in rice by embracing the BLT Balanced Nutrition Concept. It is the only way. Let BLT 625-25 and 832-16 along with our stabilized urea and microelements take you to the mountaintop. Do not be fooled by imitation fertilizer in fancy bags. Not because you are getting credit, it means that you must accept garbage. You have rights too. Call 624-1440 for more information. Thank you and God's blessings upon you.
Guyana! Guyana! The Central Housing and Planning Authority, under the patronage of the Government of Guyana, brings to you Housing Solutions 2017 and Beyond Expo, a model village of modern, stylish, and affordable housing designs. Prospective homeowners, here is your opportunity to engage with the banking and other financial institutions as well as insurance companies to discuss available financing options. The public will experience and enjoy wholesome entertainment for the entire family and savor the flavor of local and foreign cuisine as well as beverages at the food court. So tell a family, tell a friend and come visit Model Village. Housing Solutions 2017 and Beyond opens on Friday, May 26 at 15 hours and runs from May 27 to 29, time 11 to 22 hours each day at the Perseverance Housing Development site on the east bank of Demerara. Not too sure where that is? Just follow the Massey and Princess Hotel Road. This event is sponsored by Geico Construction, Guyana Bank for Trade and Industry, Republic Bank, Turgonal, New Building Society, and Quartz.
Expo, be there.
David Granger believes that the judiciary arm of government is not being hindered by the executive arm. The head of state was at the time making remarks as two judges were sworn in to sit on the appeal court. Details in this report.
I will faithfully execute the office of Justice of the Peel without fear or favor, affection or ill will, and that in the execution of the functions of that office, I will honor, uphold, and preserve the Constitution of the Cooperative Republic of Guyana, and I do so swear, so help me God.
On April 20th, 2017, the Judicial Service Commission found favor in the performance of Justices Don Gregory and Roxanne George Wilshire unanimously recommended to President David Granger for them to serve at the appeal court. The two judges' term will become effective May 17, 2017. President David Granger made mention of the constitutional requirements necessary to establish good governance.
The executive branch of government has no interest in interfering in the adjudicatory role of the judiciary. The executive has taken steps to ensure that the judiciary does not feel beholden to the government of the day. The enactment of the Fiscal Management and of Accountability Amendment Act of 2015 provided for the first time for the full financial autonomy of the judiciary in accordance with the Constitution. The executive branch of government also has no interest in interfering in the work of judiciary. It seeks only the preservation of a judiciary that is unbiased, unblemished, and unmindful of personal prejudices.
The head of state opined that the independence of the judiciary is essential to ensure the integrity of the rule of law. He noted that everyone is subjected to the law and no one is above the law. The president, however, opined that an effective judiciary should be accompanied with a full complement of magistrates and judges.
The government will support the efforts of the Judicial Service Commission in ensuring that vacancies are filled promptly in order to ensure respect for the recommendations for judicial appointments based on the objective criteria which have been prescribed. The JSC is aware that an ethically compromised judiciary can cripple the institutional mechanisms established by the legislative branch and enforced by the executive branch of government.
Nikhil John, the reporting for MTV News Update.
A 28-year-old man was this morning discovered in a pool of blood with a shot to the back of his head. The man was shot execution style and left sprawling in a pool of blood on a parapet in Roxanne Burnham Gardens. Details in this report.
That is 28-year-old Roy Rowland of Castello Housing Scheme, La Penitence, Georgetown. Rowland's body was discovered approximately 6:30 this morning on the eastern parapet of Marigold Street, Roxanne Barnum Gardens. The police in a statement said a 9mm special was found at the scene. Rowland's body bore a gunshot wound to the back of his head. A cousin of the deceased believes that Rowland was murdered and his body was dumped along the roadway. The woman said a stranger came and told them about the discovery and she went and identified the body.
I won't be able to say. The police have to do investigation. Also his friends them, the last person we saw Roy with, that we know that he leave home with. What is his name, mommy? Anybody know his name? Kizel Edwards. Yes. A shard. Yes, last night he leave 25 Castillo and he went about. This is the last person that we know him with. From there, the police will do their investigation.
Rowland, who was working as a seaman, leaves to mourn his wife, son, and an unborn child. An investigation has been launched to ascertain what may have led to the murder. No one has been arrested up to press time. Nikhil John, the reporting for MTV News Update.
Food inspectors are calling for security personnel to be present when products are being destroyed, as mandated by the government analyst Food and Drug Department. This call is being made as the inspectors claim that pickers normally remove the products before they are destroyed at the dump sites.
Lack of adequate protection has caused pickers to cart off with products before they are destroyed. This is according to Deputy Director of the Government Analyst Food and Drug Department, Joel Sears. According to her, two inspectors are usually sent at point of sale sites or, if necessary, dump sites in cases where expired or spoiled goods are mandated to be destroyed. However, inspectors are faced with the presence of pickers who often appear at the sites to seal goods, using it for sale or consumption purposes.
Yes, in addition to the protection, for inspections, particularly at point of sales that are at the marketplaces, we need adequate staff to be able to cover the country or the food safety program of the country. For we look at those who import, distribute, sell, as well as manufacture.
Another worrying issue is insufficient inspectors. This has caused the department to be unable to inspect each business premises. Meanwhile, the department has been clamping down on products which pose threats to consumers' health. Sandy Ramotar for MTV's News Update.
Coming up, Carter Center tells Guyana to change its electoral process. A new Region 9 REO bettering the region, says the regional chairman.
I found love in you, and I've learned to love me too. Never have I felt that I could be all that you see. It's like our hearts have intertwined.
John Lewis Styles, Simply Different.
This is why I love you.
You can be a millionaire by only spending $100 on a Daily Million ticket. Simply pick any 5 numbers from 1 to 26, or you can buy a quick pick for your chance to win the Daily Millions. Purchase your tickets daily, Monday through Saturday, to get a chance to win $1 million every day. So, feeling lucky? Then buy a Daily Millions ticket today. Remember, a ticket today could make you rich today.
Welcome to Rosignol's Butchery. Here you'll find the freshest, most tender and flavorful meats, including steaks, burgers, sausages, minced meat, fish, and more, plus packaged meats and cheeses. All this in a highly hygienic atmosphere. In our store, there is a wide variety of canned goods, sauces, and marinades. Our friendly staff will cater to all your needs. Rosignol Butchery, We meet your needs. 7374 Church Street, Georgetown. Telephone 223-0004.
Honda revolutionized the way we traveled 10 years ago with the CR-V. And Honda has now advanced on and off-road travel even more with the 2016 CR-V. It's loaded with the latest technology in braking and four-wheel drive power transmission to make your journey safer and more comfortable. Now the Honda HR-V has joined the range. It's smaller, but has all the advancements of the CR-V and is more affordable. The Honda CR-V and HR-V. Economical, safe, powerful, and affordable. The 2016 Ultimate Family Vehicle. See it at Marex today.
On MTV. The Carter Center has recommended a change to the electoral process in Guyana. This is contained in the center's final report on Guyana's 2015 general and regional elections. Details in this report.
In the final report, the Carter Center made recommendations to the Parliament of Guyana to allow individual candidates to stand for president. It noted that the constitutional rules in Guyana limit all candidature for the office of the presidency and for membership of the National Assembly to those who joined party lists. It also noted that the parliament should make an amendment to the constitution to facilitate this change and should be considered as a matter of some urgency. The center in its final report says the parliament must strengthen the right to an effective remedy in electoral dispute resolution. The National Assembly should also consider revision of the validity of Elections Act 1964 or any subsequent legislation to ensure that reasonable time limits are in place to ensure the settlement of any election complaints and petitions. Currently in Guyana, cases including election petitions can be active for years and for longer than the duration of the body or government whose election is being contested. The center recommends that an overhaul should be done to modernize campaign finance laws and to create a law on political parties, ensure geographical seats are more equitably distributed among electors. The Carter Center recommends that the government continue to strengthen the professionalism and independence of GCOM and to build confidence in the voters list. It noted that GCOM, on the other hand, should open their meetings to observers and to ensure respect for the right of prisoners to vote. Also, it should strengthen the process of tabulating results and to clearly mark vehicles for transport of election materials. The last election saw the coalition party securing victory, which reflects the present-day government. However, the People's Progressive Party cried foul, claiming that the elections were rigged. The party currently has an election petition in the High Court, challenging the authenticity of the results. Nikhil John, the reporting for MTV News Update.
Residents of Upper Takutu, Upper Essequibo will now see massive development in the region as works are moving at a fast pace following the appointment of the new regional executive officer.
This follows the sacking of the former regional executive officer, Carl Parker, after being charged for sexual assault. This is according to Chairman of Region 9, Brian Alicock. According to him, the council has not received any complaints against the official, Kevin Ward, who took office in February of this year.
Now, since I've gotten the new REO, we've been moving apace in that we're getting through with most of the tendering, most of the that's regional tendering, as well as we're looking at the national tendering now. They're today looking at the capital releases for the regional expenditure. And, you know, he's working day and night. And
while he's said to be acting in the position, Alicock is hopeful he can be confirmed as a new face to deal with the administrative issues in the council.
He is better in a sense of that he is very open and transparent, and, you know, he's very inclusive also, and he doesn't do anything by himself, taking his own decisions. He confirms to all on sundry that, okay, if he needs to do something, he don't do it on his own. He would conform with the RDC, which we control, and the administrative arm, which he controls.
The new REO has been appointed following sexual allegations levied against Parker, who has been sent on leave by the Communities Ministry. The new appointee, formerly from the Regentry Administration, was appointed on February 20, 2017, as a replacement for Parker. While Parker was on duty, the relationship between him and the regional chair was sore. Sandy Ramutar for MTV's News Update.
Mayor of Linden, Carwin Holland, says that the Linden Hospital Complex is seeking to find a solution for the shortage of drugs. The mayor says that the regional chairman is working assiduously to rectify the issue.
The minister within the Ministry of Public Health, Dr. Karen Cummins, has declared a shortage of drugs at a number of hospitals. It is no different for the town of Linden. The Linden Hospital Complex has been experiencing drug shortages. However, the Regional Democratic Council, RDC, is doing as much as possible to fix the problem, said the mayor of Linden, Carwin Holland. He said that there is a nationwide drug shortage, and Linden is trying its best to maintain the situation and is working along with several regional representatives to tackle the issue.
This has been something going on for many years. However, I'm happy and I'm proud to say that we've seen aggressive steps being taken by Minister Valdi Lawrence to rid our township of problems like this.
Last month, a visit by the Parliamentary Sectoral Committee on the Social Services to the Linden Hospital Complex revealed several issues, including the drug shortages, a dysfunctional ECG machine, shortage of cutting-edge needles, inefficient monitors, issues with the sections of the roof, cracks in some parts of the building, and the need for more dental staff.
More news still ahead. Stay with us.
Hey, you have a growing flesh there, and there too, and there is another one. Those ugly and annoying growing flesh, like a plague, ignoring them, and before you know, you have them everywhere. SlimJet presenting Coliomac, the most effective growing flesh and wart remover. Painlessly remove ugly growing flesh is the quick and effective way. Get soft, smooth, growing flesh-free skin, guarantee. Just apply Coliomac twice a day and the growing flesh just dry up and fall off. Easy, quick, and painless. Stop suffering and feeling embarrassed. Remove those ugly growing flesh with Coliomac. Only at SlimJet, City Mall, second floor, or in New Amsterdam, 22 Asylum and Main Road, Berbice.
Installing. Modern Optical Service has made it even better by introducing its budgeted spectacle line, starting as low as $10,000 for single vision lens and $12,000 for bifocal lens, available in tinted or clear, complete spectacles at affordable prices. So hurry down to our main office at 316 Middle Street or Lot 14 Diamond Public Road opposite Demerara Bank. Enjoy over 60 years of eye care experience at affordable prices. Modern Optical Service, your eye care professionals. You're still with News Update, welcome back. Upper Takutu, Upper Essequibo Regional Chairman Brian Ali Cock is awaiting for contracts to be given out for the construction of roads due to the May-June rain.
The May-June rainy season has stepped in, and the problem that Region 9 faces still persists. Drainage of the Rupununi region is a sore problem. However, the chairman of the region, Brian Ali Cock, said it is a work in progress. The regional chairman said that another challenge the region is facing is the lack of infrastructural development, as the contracts are yet to be issued for roads to be built in the region.
The rains are telling us it is here already, because we have some continuous rainfall. The rivers are coming up, but not very rapidly, but the earth is being soaked. So when the heavy rains do come, we'll have the high rains coming.
He also mentioned that Region 8 road development project has been published in the local newspaper and is hoping the same can be done for his region. Ali Cock said that if contracts are awarded, works can begin.
Those contracts that could be awarded and work could be done during the rains, we would do that. And the remainder just to complete by November, so that, you know, come December we don't have any overlapping or overriding or taking over to the other year. So we're working towards that, so that we'll be in line with whatever we projected for our budget and the works to be completed on time.
The prison survey, which is being facilitated by the Citizen Security Strengthening Programs Component 3 and facilitated by the University of Guyana, is expected to submit a draft report by September 2017. The sum of US$74,200 has been allocated for the survey. Faculty staff from both Turkine and Tain campuses, including medical and legal personnel, mathematicians, criminologists, and social workers, will comprise the core team leading the survey. Additionally, 30 students from the university will be trained in data collection to assist the team in conducting the survey. In their bid to provide psychological interventions for women, children, and families from all walks of life, Eureka Lab has evolved with a psychodiagnostic family center.
The Syndicators for Multidisciplinary Behavioral Health Care Practice that offers psychological services. With more than 20 years' experience under her belt, psychologist and floral and sex therapist Lisandro Hirajo Boza says she specializes to deal with emotional problems and those relating to needs of sexual therapy.
With the sexual therapy, we're referring to the person that needs help with the behavior sexual, the sexual behavior. For example, a couple with problem, vaginism, sometimes ejaculation in the with problem in the men, in the woman, and the person don't have orgasm.
Following the 6 days after the launch, psychologist Ren Gonzalez says the feedback has been tremendous, with information on psychotherapy reaching some 50,000 people countrywide. According to him, majority of clients needed assistance for panic attacks, followed closely by depression and other mental ills.
Okay, usually it's supposed to be, it starts with a psychological test. We cannot say, I am depressed. If a client would say, I am depressed, I would not take that as it is. She may be lonely, but she may not be depressed. So we have tests that measure depression. We have tests that measure certain disorders. We have tests that can measure brain damage. We have tests that can actually measure some personality traits that may be needed for a job. So we can measure how emotionally stable you are.
Services offered at the center include family diagnosis and therapy, women crisis intervention, substance abuse, contracted mental health services, among others. Sandy Ramutar for MTV's News Update.
As the world celebrates Telecommunication and Information Society Day, the subject ministry pledged to develop ideas in the information, telecommunication and communication sector to catapult the country.
The Ministry of Public Telecommunication, in conjunction with the International Telecommunication Union, celebrates the World Telecom and Information Society Day under the theme Big Data, Big Impact. Minister of Public Telecommunication Catherine Hughes says that every business, government agency, NGO, person and educational institution have access to numerous amounts of structured and unstructured data every second of every day. Since the establishment of the Public Telecommunications Ministry in 2016, numerous achievements have been made, like designing an application for safer pension payments, providing schools, community centers, government ministries and public service departments with the fast internet. The minister has assured all stakeholders and communities that the Ministry of Public Telecommunications is open to working with them to develop new ideas that will utilize ICT to take the nation to the heights it has the potential to reach.
Stay tuned for regional and international news, court roundup, as well as the Ghana Stock Exchange.
IFED asks, are you involved in agriculture? Do you have crops, livestock or poultry? Do you need finance to grow or expand your farms?
IFED agriculture loans from $40,000 to $20 million are designed to meet your needs. Repayment terms are based on crop cycle.
IFED works and supports you through difficult times,
with advice on technology and mentoring.
Contact any of our 13 offices countrywide.
IFED, improving livelihoods.
Get going, keep growing with iPad.
Gafoos has been Guyana's largest manufacturer of steel products since 1970, and we were the first to introduce alu zinc and pre-painted corrugated sheets, which are produced in several widths and gauges and can be cut to any desired length. They're available in ripple, non-ripple, clay tile, non-clay tile, and trapezoidal designs. We supplement our corrugated sheets with curved sheets and ridging in alu zinc and pre-painted finishes. Also, galvanized deckings for casting concrete floors, manufactured in several thicknesses, and can be cut to any length from 6 feet to 30 feet. Some of the other products produced by us are galvanized purlin in widths of 4, 6, and 8 inches, and to lengths 6 feet to 40 feet. BRC fabric in sheets 6.35 millimeters, sizes 20 feet by 8 feet, suitable for heavy concrete flooring or areas of heavy traffic. At Gafoos, we produce the best quality at the most competitive prices and also offer the best services in the hardware business. All our steel products are available at any of our 7 locations countrywide. Gafoos, the name you can trust.
We are the experts when it comes to creative marketing, brand campaigns, concept development, and production.
With our diverse knowledge and tactical marketing strategies, we are the go-to company to reignite your brand. Having been in the industry for over 20 years, we're Ghana's number one choice for brand development.
Did you know almost one-third of deaths in Guyana are heart-related? Chronic inflammation is the root cause of atherosclerosis, the process that leads to cholesterol-clogged arteries. You can now lower high triglyceride levels with Omega XL and reduce the dangerous inflammation that causes these problems. So to ensure a healthy heart and reduce your risk of disease, get your Omega XL today. Live long, stay strong with Omega XL.
Let me go.
This is what went down at the Zhuoshang Magistrates Court on Wednesday, May 17.
A man has been released on $250,000 bail after denying a charge of embezzlement when he appeared before Magistrate Fabio Azor. Naipaul Hari, 34, of Diamond, East Bang Damarara, denied a charge which alleged that between May 1 and May 31, 2016, while being employed at Ram Gobain Mohanlal, he fraudulently embezzled $4,977,000, monies taken in possession by him on behalf of his employer. Police prosecutor Simone Payne did not oppose bail for the defendant, but requested that same be in a substantial amount. Naipaul Hari, who was unrepresented by an attorney, was ordered to return to court on June 7. A man accused of threatening and assaulting a woman he lives with appeared in the Georgetown Magistrates Courts this morning and pleaded not guilty to two charges. Particulars of the first charge against Lennon Williams alleged that on May 11 at Sophia, he made use of threatening language towards Leslyn Marks, whereby a breach of the peace made the occasion. It was further alleged that on May 12 at a said location, he unlawfully assaulted a woman. The charges were however dismissed by Magistrate Fabio Azor because the virtual complainant refused to offer evidence against the Williams. Leslyn Marks told the court that she does not want to have a relationship with the man anymore and that she wanted him to remove from her premises. Lennon Williams said that he would comply and that he has accepted the fact that a woman no longer wants to be with him. Meanwhile, in another case, a vendor was ordered to pay a fine of $8,000 after pleading guilty to making use of threatening behavior to a man who his brother had a fight with. Philip Jones, 25, of La Penitence, Georgetown, admitted that on May 14 at Kroll Street, he made use of threatening behavior towards Godfrey Gittins. It was also alleged that on the same day, he unlawfully assaulted Gittins. The defendant pleaded not guilty to this charge and was released on $15,000 bail by Magistrate Azor. The matter will be called again on May 18. Finally, Alvin Jones, also known as Hot Skull, has been remanded to prison for murder when he appeared before Chief Magistrate Anne McLennan. Jones, 25, a fish cleaner of Castello Housing Scheme, Georgetown, was not required to plead to the indictable charge which alleged that on February 2 at Independence Boulevard, he murdered Paul Daniels of Schoonard, West Bang Demerara, during the course of a robbery. Police prosecutor Arvin Moore indicated that a case file is still incomplete. The matter was subsequently adjourned until May 12. Based on reports, Paul Daniels, 39, was shot by bandits during a robbery. At the time of the killing, the man was visiting his girlfriend. He was robbed of a gold chain and a small sum of cash. Police had said that Daniels was shot when he attempted to pursue the two bandits. Godfrey Brooms, MTV, News Update.
The Ghana Stock Exchange closing prices for trading session 7:21. Let's turn our attention to the Demerara Harbor Bridge schedule. Rajesh Lakhan is next with Star Technology Wrap.
Nothing compares to the class and beauty of Beeson Windows and Doors. Engineered by professionals and built to last longer than the competition. Buy 10 windows and get one 24x16 bathroom window absolutely free. No tricks, no gimmicks, and no hidden fees. Prices starting from 13.5 VAT inclusive. So visit our showroom today at Lot 1228 New Eccles Industrial Site or BPAT's building on Regent Street and save big on UPVC or aluminum windows. To order now, call 622-4197 or 226-1292.
And see you, Jerry!
Join MTV Channel 14 Cable 65 from April 5 to May 21 for the most spectacular T20 cricket, the 10th Vivo Indian Premier League 2017. All matches, including the qualifiers and final, will be televised. Watch 8 excellent teams compete: Sunrisers Hyderabad, Royal Challengers Bangalore, Kolkata Knight Riders and others. Place your commercials during these super matches. Call now, let's design a package that suits your budget. For further details, please call your advertising agency or our friendly marketing team on 226-3593 or 225-0569.
The Central Housing and Planning Authority, under the patronage of the Government of Guyana, brings to you Housing Solutions 2017 and Beyond Expo, a model village of modern, stylish, and affordable housing designs. Prospective homeowners, here is your opportunity to engage with the banking and other financial institutions as well as insurance companies to discuss available financing options. The public will experience and enjoy wholesome entertainment for the entire family and savor the flavor of local and foreign cuisine as well as beverages at the food court. So tell a family, tell a friend, and come visit Model Village. Housing Solutions 2017 and Beyond opens on Friday, May 26 at 15 hours and runs from May 27 to 29, time 11 to 22 hours each day at the Perseverance Housing Development Site on the east bank of Demerara. Not too sure where that is? Just follow the Massey and Princess Hotel Road. This event is sponsored by Geico Construction, Guyana Bank for Trade and Industry, Republic Bank, Turgonal, New Building Society, and Courts.
Expo, be there!
MTV's weekly special feature.
Good evening and welcome to this special edition of Star Technology Wrap. Today, Stars will be officially launching the Samsung Galaxy S8 in store. And to tell us more about this Samsung flagship phone, I have with me Raiden and Yannick. Guys, go ahead and tell us everything about it.
All right, good evening, viewers. So today, we're going to be talking about the Samsung Galaxy S8 and S8 Plus.
First of all, Yannick, do you have anything you want to say about the phone before we get
well,
started?
Well, first off, Raiden, you know, I mean, I'm holding this phone right now and it's an amazing phone. I think Samsung has really taken it to another level. You know, it's like the futuristic phone. Excellent screen quality. I mean, it feels so good in your hands. And I think everyone should really come and get one of these phones right now.
Yeah, I think so too. So let's just touch on some of the basic features or some of the exciting features that the phone has to offer. First of all, in terms of security, Yannick, you know, in the past, all the phones were limited to just either password patterns or just fingerprint, basic.
Yeah.
Now, Samsung has actually gone a step further.
Wow.
Now, the S8 and S8 Plus, they actually have iris scanning, facial recognition, fingerprint scanner still, and also you could use the conventional password and pattern.
Okay.
So it's actually multiple ways you can actually unlock your phone. So this phone is actually, security-wise, is top-notch, honestly.
And, for those out there who don't really understand exactly what iris scanning is, it's actually you being able to unlock the phone by just looking at it. I mean, you can just look at your phone and it's unlocked. That's pretty cool. That's really easy. And it's perfect for persons, you know, let's say you're out, you're in the rain or something. Sometimes your finger gets wet and you can't really scan, you know, the fingerprint scanner. You can actually just look at the phone and, you know, it's unlocked. You can get to access all your features easily
right there. Speaking about rain, Yannick, the S8 and S8 Plus, it's still IP68.
Yes.
So that means it's dust and water resistant. So you still have those, that nice feature still included with the phone. You know.
And you know, I heard a lot of persons talking about this infinity screen. You know.
Yeah.
It's a really really cool screen. What that really means, you know, infinity screen. They've actually increased the screen size on the phone, so you're not really getting a bigger phone, but you're getting more screen area on the actual device. So you get the same size basically, but with a bigger area of screen, so you're going to be able to access more pictures. You can see a little bit more content on your phone, and it feels great. So it's not a bigger phone, but it's the same size, and you get a bigger screen display.
Also, the edges are curved, so
both displays get a curved screen on both devices.
And they remove the actual home button, so there's no physical home button. So that means a bigger screen. The phone buttons are actually virtual.
Yeah, and you can actually switch them around for persons, you know, might be left-handed, you might be right-handed. You can switch them around for your own convenience if you'd like to do that. All right, so let's talk about something that's a little bit more interesting. I mean, everybody is talking about Bixby, you know, it sounds really cool and really nice, but Raiden, tell the customers out there, you know, the viewers, what exactly is Bixby?
So basically, to put it in a nutshell, Bixby is like your personal assistant. So it's the best level of artificial intelligence out there. You could actually, it has a feature called Bixby Vision, where you can basically pull up your camera, activate the feature, and you can point at an option. Say I pointed my watch on my hand, and it's gonna actually do a search for the watch online, probably take me to some site to purchase a watch similar to this, but it's gonna actually see that it is a watch and do a search for it. So it's actually a very exciting feature.
I also read too, Raiden, that when you, as you continuously use Bixby, it learns your pattern. So let's say you like to eat at a favorite place or stuff, you know, and you say, oh, Bixby, you can actually talk to it. You can say, you know, I want to find churches or somewhere, you know, it can actually show you the location, and it's really fast, really easy to use, and it's making life easier for us. You know, Samsung is all about making things more exceptional and pushing it beyond the limits.
Correct. Let's talk about some features that, you know, a lot of customers look for, like, for example, taking a photo. Now the S8 and S8 Plus is actually what they call selfie friendly. So basically you can take photos easier, simpler, by just actually moving the top of your hands on the sensor and you can actually take a photo very instantly. And they also, the camera has built-in stickers, which is like filters, so you can actually put stickers on your actual pictures as you take them.
Yeah, so for all you guys out there that are into Snapchatting, you know, you get all those filters already built in on the phone, so you can take all your amazing pictures there. And Raiden didn't mention this, but you're getting a better camera, a front camera on the S8 and the S8 Plus.
Correct.
You're getting 8 megapixels, so with autofocus. So
correct, with smart autofocus,
actually, so it's
better. Basic feature functionalities of the phone, like performance, like the processor, the camera, all those are better. But what I want to touch on is the first phone, the S8 and S8 Plus, is the first phone to actually have Bluetooth 5.0 built in. So basically, it's going to be faster, it's going to have more range and everything. So we're going to look forward to see more devices coming out with Bluetooth 5.0, and this is the first phone with it.
So that's basically a basic rundown on the S8 and the S8 Plus. You know, we're unboxing the phone here at Star Computers, and we're allowing you guys to come in and actually be able to feel the phone. You can test drive it, as we say here at Star Computer. Come in and check it out. Connect to our Facebook page, like it, share it with your friends, and thank you once again, guys. And we'll now hand you back over to Rajesh.
Well, thank you, guys, and that's all we have for you on this week's edition of Star Technology Wrap. Do join us next week, Wednesday, for another edition.
That sums up our newscast for tonight, but before we go, here's a recap of our major headlines. New ombudsman identified. Seaman found dead with gunshot to the back of his head. Executive arm of government not impeding on the judiciary's functions, says President Granger. Carter Center recommends changes to the electoral process. Development in Region 9 progressing on the new REO. Drug shortages in Linden being rectified. And in court, Alvin Hotskull Jones remanded for murder. The newscast can be viewed online on MTV's Facebook page and also on our YouTube channel. The news will be rebroadcasted later tonight at 23 hours and at 6 hours on Thursday, May 18. On behalf of our news team, I am Ashley Scotland, thanking you for watching. Good night.